Now, we saw that the form in which we had written the Coulomb's law, that is this form does not have the direction information to it. While we know that force is a vector and our equation should have reflected it, okay? So we set out to incorporate the direction feature into it, okay? And that is quite an easy thing to do. Now we start with defining a Cartesian plane where this is my origin, okay? We know that there are position vectors whose tail is at the origin and whose head is at the point of interest, wherever you are trying to point it out, right? So let us say I have a point this and say another point absolutely randomly located. So no need that it is horizontal or whatever. That's why I have drawn it this way, slightly above this. Now what happens? This vector, the vector this, is the position vector where my charge Q1 is placed. Okay? Where my charge Q1 is placed. Correct? And this is the point where my charge Q2 is placed. Correct? Now, so the position PV, the position vector of Q1 is R1 and that of Q2 is R2. Okay? You get the point. Now what? Let us take Q1, Q2 greater than 0. This, what does it mean? That either both of them are positive or both of them are negative. When I say Q1 and Q2, I mean along with their signs. Now later we'll release this condition, don't worry. But we are first investigating it when Q1, Q2 is greater than 0. Now when Q1, Q2 is greater than 0, that is both of them are either positive or both of them are negative, the force will be repulsive, and we know from Coulomb's law that this force points in this direction while this force points in this direction. Correct? Okay? Now this force we call force F21 and this as F12. Why? Because F21 is defined as the force on Q2 due to 1. Okay? Due to Q1. Understand? So on Q2, this is due to Q1. Correct? Okay? This is a convention that we'll follow. The effect is first, the cause is later. Who causes it is later. F12 is the force on 1 Q1 due to Q2. Okay? So this again means on Q1, this means due to Q2. Okay? This is the convention we'll follow. Now, on to, due to one, the force is pointing in this direction. Right. Let us try to find out a vector that points in that direction using these two. Okay. So let us try to understand. We know the law of addition of vectors. Okay. What does it mean? How do you add two vectors? You put them head to tail. Right. You put them head to tail. So there is a vector like this. This is R1. I'm drawing this miniaturized version. And there is a vector this. This is your R2, right? This is your R2. Suppose I want to know this vector. Which vector? This, the green vector. This vector. You see? So I do not know what that vector is. I call it X vector. Now, by our law of addition of vectors, what happens? R1 plus X is equal to R2. Do we see that? Why? Because the vectors are added head to tail. We see that. They are added head to tail. So X vector is equal to R2 minus R1. Okay, it is R2 minus R1, and this I call as R21. Okay, this I call as R21. So somehow I have got a vector in the direction of F21, is it not? I have got a vector in the direction of F21. Now, this is R21, right? Now, I do not want that. I will try to find out a unit vector in that direction. What is a unit vector? A vector which has length? 1. Unity. 1. Okay? So R21 cap is R21 upon R21. I have divided it by the magnitude of the same vector, and then there is nothing like division by scalars. So it is actually, this is nothing but division, multiplication by reciprocal of the magnitude. And what happens to a vector when you multiply it by reciprocal by any scalar? By any scalar, what happens if you multiply it by any scalar, and this is positive, R21, the magnitude is the length is positive. So you can, you see, R21, the magnitude, you can either write as this, magnitude of R21, magnitude of R21 can be either written as this or this. Okay. So you can write this with this, but that is more cumbersome. So I do not prefer it. This is equal to, what happens when you multiply a vector with the scalar? The magnitude of the vector becomes scalar times its own magnitude. So what is the magnitude of this? R21. And it gets multiplied by 1 by R21. So it actually becomes length 1. Okay, and in that format, it is called R21 cap.
Why are we taking R21
cap? We'll see that. So R21 cap is equal to R21 upon R21. It will soon become clear why we are dealing with this. Now, F21, I know the direction. I know a unit vector in that direction. So what happens? my force, the magnitude of my force is what?
It is K Q1 Q2 upon R square.
I multiply it with a vector of unit length R21. What happens? What is the, when R21 gets multiplied by this scalar, what happens to the magnitude of this vector R21 on multiplication with this? It gets multiplied by this whole thing. You see that? This is a scalar multiplication of this unit vector. It already had its length as 1. So its length simply becomes this magnitude multiplied by 1, which is the magnitude itself. So the force has a magnitude that we wanted.
And a direction also that we
wanted. And the direction has been given by R21 cap. So it becomes a vector of length so much, which we wanted. And the direction is towards R21, which again we wanted. Do we get that? Many a times you could see the same equation written as Q1, Q2 upon R square into R21 instead of this cap. Cap is meant specifically for unit vectors, right? This divided by R, this is, and what is R? R is nothing but R21. The length, this length is equal to R21. So I write this as R21. Or leave it here, R. I write it here. You understand why? Because it somehow matches with this, no? If there is an F21, so there is an 21 and 21, right? So this divided by this. So this becomes K Q1 Q2 upon R21 cube into R21.
Now this looks strange. We never started with a cube in the denominator.
How has this dropped in? Why? Because somehow this already had a length R21 that got multiplied with your magnitude. So the magnitude here became how much? R21 multiplied by this. One R21 goes into cancel this R21 length, and other R21 whole square is from the Coulomb's law. No, this is scalar. Scalar multiplication. This is neither dot. That's a good question. This is neither a dot product nor a cross product. It is a scalar multiplication of a vector. Understand? And what does scalar multiplication say? Hope you remember. Scalar multiplication says that if you multiply a vector by A into R, then the length of the vector becomes A times whatever it was, and the direction remains the same if A is positive. If say I multiplied by minus AR, then what happens? The length becomes A times R, but minus sign changes the direction of the vector. So that is what you have to keep in mind. Understand? So this becomes my equation, the vector equation of the Coulomb's law. Pretty simple, right? Now it has all the information. I need not even tell what information is there and what needs to be incorporated. Understand? We understand that. Now, how about F12? F12 has a vector. F12 is towards, is in this direction. It is opposite to the vector R21. Do you get that? It is in the direction which is opposite to R21. And there is a very simple way in which I can make R21 positive.
R21, if you put a negative, becomes what? R2 minus R1 vector with a negative sign. This becomes R1 minus R2. I have done nothing.
The distributive property of negative getting distributed over this.
And this becomes R12.
You get that? It becomes R12. So R12 is nothing but minus R21. Understand? And similarly, R12 cap is nothing but R12 divided by R12 whole square. Okay. So F12 is equal to KQ1 Q2 upon R12 whole square multiplied by R12. Is it not? Which becomes also R12 upon R12. This is R12 whole square, which can give you KQ1 Q2 upon R12 whole cube R12. So these are two alternate forms. Let us be clear about it. One of the forms is this. And for the same, the other form is when you have an R12 whole cube in the denominator. But here, instead of a unit vector, you have the normal vector, right? So either this or that. Okay. Here too, either this or that. So here too, I have F21 is equal to this. This holds. Okay. Oh, hold on. So maybe these two are the same. No? So I should write that separately. I'll write it. This is F12. This is F21. Is it not? This is. No, it's quite simple. So F21 I can write as KQ1 Q2 upon R21 whole square into R21 cap. Okay, nothing so great about it, so don't get scared. They are the two things that you should understand, you should remember. So these two are for F21 alternate forms, and these two are for F12. We understand? So this simple equation incorporates our force feature, and that will become very, very important when you are dealing with force due to multiple charges. Okay, it makes your job pretty simple. Okay.